So Haley made this paper bag star last week in art club, and she let me keep it, which is awesome. And we were going to make them in the 6th and 7th grade art club this week, but since we can't meet, I thought I'd make a video. Now there's a video about how to make these on my YouTube playlist. What I'm doing now is just priming it. I watered down some white paint. There's Vincent. I think I watered it down too much, but I just want to give it a little coat so it picks up some color a little bit better. Yeah, I think it'll work. Just absorbing it a little more than I expected. I'm going to splatter paint it. So I thought, well, if I prime it first, it'll be a little brighter. Now we followed the directions on the Crayola website and it actually showed us how to paint the insides of the bags, and they just don't show at all. Just kind of depressing, because you can see here Haley put some nice details in with watercolor paint and you really just can't see them. So the video really should have said just paint the sides of the bags. Because that's what's gonna show. Now, the instructions also said use 8 bags, but Haley used 10 bags here, which was great. I made another one with 12 bags that I'm gonna show you in just a minute. And these are large lunch bags or craft sacks, I don't know what you call them. Brown paper bags. These are the large size, but I made another one that's normal size. Again, if I were to do this again, I probably would not have watered down the white paint as much as I did, but it may take 2 coats and that'll be fine. You could use any paint you had. You don't even have to paint it white first. You could use watercolor paint. You could even decorate this beforehand with marker or colored pencil. Oops, I'm making a mess. Forgot to bring my apron home from school, unfortunately. May have to go back and get that. It's kind of my essential paint smock. All right, so while this is drying, I'm going to show you the other one that I made. So this is actually 12 lunch sacks glued together. I made these flip out first. After I glued them, I cut the triangle like it said on the website that I found this on. And it actually showed how you can cut out of the sides, kind of like a snowflake. You could cut here and here. I think I'm just going to leave it kind of plain. But watch what this does. It's just gorgeous. Kind of fans out. This will be awesome hanging from the ceiling in here. Or in front of a window, it'd be fantastic. So actually, before I do this, I'm gonna put some glue. I just wanna make sure I had enough bags. I brought like one of everything home from school. One bottle of glue, one good pair of scissors, one ruler. Actually, check this out. Sweet. I even brought home one clothespin. I use these all the time in the art room when I'm gluing things. Should have brought 2. But I think I'm gonna flip this around, glue this together. I just need to hold it in place temporarily, so maybe I can. The clothespin on one side and my handy dandy hands on the other side. You can see how beautiful that is. Well, that's drying. I'm gonna go back and give my Haley Samuels Paper Star a second coat. It's a little too watery, but that's okay. Can you come up here, Vincent? Can you come up here, Vincent? Meow. I've saved all sorts of things to make stuff with. Let's see if I can go a little higher so you can see this guy. This furry guy. Uh-oh, he found the fairy wand. That's what he wants. He thinks that's a cat toy. I think that's a cat toy, huh? Ooh, believe me, it's got bells, tassels. Yeah. Baby. Let me play with that right there. All right, well, I'm gonna let this dry and I'll show you later how to splatter paint it. Actually, I have a fan here I'm gonna put right on that. See if I can get it to dry a little bit faster. And I'll see you later. Hi, Vincent.